Hey guys, this is Kevin. Today we're going to work on this Epson Printhead. This is extreme cleaning. If your printhead is missing a couple pixels, follow my other video, not this one. We're going to work on this FA04000. Epson usually put those on entry-level printers. We got those from people already tried to refurbish it. They gave up because there's no way they can unclog it. Let's see if we can save them from landfill. This side of this FFC cable also has a sponge, and we cut this up. We're going to always point this upward. There are four seal points. This first one, and then the second one, third one, and fourth one. Here's everything we need to unclog it. FFA cable points to the sky. And we're going to work on the left and the right side. On the side, you're going to see a seam. Point your razor blade inside it. Just simple twist, you're going to see those seals fall off. Two fall off, and there are two more. I'll do it a little bit slower, see? Twist, that thing falls off. Okay, and twist one more time, that thing falls off. After the four seals fall off, you give a harder twist. Twist. And then you can use your finger, push it up, and they're going to separate. Okay, now it's moment of truth. Inside it, it should look oval. Okay, oval. However, if you open it up, the inside look like maids, look like this. Okay, bad news and good news. The bad news is this video is not for you. Actually, the worst news is I did not make a kit to make this kind of print networks. And the good news is you get a really rare F040. I did about 4,000 F040 printheads, and this is the only one I found. Okay, so I don't want to for this really rare one make a kit for it. But just a warning, there is a possibility you open up your printhead and you'll never be able to put it back. Okay, now we can see the problem. The ink accumulates here, become a sort of like a paste, really thick paste. So there's no way that you can push your ink through. Even if you push it through and get unclogged, and after a while it's going to re-aggregate and just block the print. And you can see there's a metal mesh, and you can see that all the dry ink on it. So there's no way you can unclog it without opening it up. I usually refurbish five at a time. For this video, let's do three so we don't make this video for too long. I got a customer from Hawaii just said that my video is always too long and too wordy. I just don't know how to do it fast. Maybe I can do like a TikTok, like a 30 seconds unclogging, just not gonna work. So second one, same problem. I don't know about Hawaiian people, but I think most people in the United States are going to enjoy seeing me do this. Oh my God, look at that. It's like a tar. Wow, there's no way you can unclog that. Yet another one. I'll save the best part for you. I had a Toyota Corolla. I was trying to kill it, so I did not change oil for 2.5 years. And this is what it looked like afterward. I couldn't kill it, so I gave it to my friends, and my friend couldn't kill it. He gave it to a cousin in Michigan, and we're sure the weather in Michigan is going to kill it. Very important is you have to make sure that your manifold works. So during lots of time, you put everything back, and it's not the clogging inside your printhead, it's the clogging in your manifold. For the manifold, we use ultrasonic cleaner to clean them even more. And you can see for the third printhead, the manifold was clogged so bad, I just cannot push water through the manifold, no matter what I try. I'm going to also put it in the ultrasonic cleaner. And after the cleaning, you can see it's still clogged. You can give it more time, even putting the boiling water and try to open it up. For us, we just threw it away because we have so many of those. And we don't want it mixed up with other manifold. Now going to work on the printhead itself. Remember the FFC cable pointing to the sky. Okay, you always want to do this so you don't put water inside your FFC cable. If you put in there, you're done. Okay, now we use a square bottle and gently clean the mesh. You're gonna clean it until there's no more ink coming out. And the second one, make sure that the cable points to the sky. And the third one. Have you wondered why our sink look like that? We already have dried manifold saved up. We already just unclogged the black one. Once the black is unclogged, everything else is unclogged. Black one is the one with a sponge on the sponge side. Or if your sponge fall off, is the point label side, the serial number side to your left, and the sponge side is up. After a while, you might see more ink coming out, so we watch the mouth. And now we're going to put a gasket to seal this printhead. We go to bchtechnology.com and we search for the word FA04000, maybe two more zeros. We're going to use this printhead gasket. If you want to have the whole kit, you can get the whole kit from here. Again, FFC point to the sky. You're going to see there are two sides of the gasket. One side have little big grooves, that one with the grooves pointing down. Or if you put an FFC cable point to the sky and there's no way it can go wrong. And the manifold, the sponge side points up, or the label side points to the left. And now you want to be flush and even. And we're going to attach tube on the black. For the clamp, I like to clamp all the way to the end of the printhead so you can form this arc and do not kink your tube. Other side the same. Again, I usually just unclog the black. Once the black is unclogged, everything is good. Now attach the black tube to the syringe and make sure you use a distilled water, okay? Not tap water, use distilled water. Again, very important, FFC side point to where? Yeah, points up. Now we can squeeze and you can see, okay? I found this printhead really hardy, okay? Don't be shy to squeeze it out. You can see the clog with your eyes, okay? Now the one on the right side is clogged. You can see there's some missing there, and there you can see the black ink coming out. It's clogged. Again, this printhead is really hardy, so don't be shy. You will not be able to damage it. Okay, actually, I was trying to. Oh, it's totally unclogged. How nice. I was trying to kill it, and almost it's like a Toyota Corolla. Second one, again, groove side down, smooth side up. This one, you're going to see the black. It's not all unclogged. And you can see on the right side is clogged. But on the left side, slowly, you're going to see the ink get unclogged. So like you just do this like a position and just a syringe after syringe of distilled water, and eventually you're going to slowly get it unclogged. We're going to try a couple of tips. One is give a little bit massage, wear gloves to this, and massage a little bit and then squeeze. Still not open. Okay, still clogged. Again, just time. Second trick is to sit aside for a couple hours, then come back. In the meantime, we're going to do the number three. And you're going to tell me whether it's clogged or not, okay? Based on your knowledge. Is it clogged? It is clogged now. Yeah, it's still clogged. Is it still clogged? Yes, it's on the left. Clog is on the left. And, okay. Massage, water. Look. Perfect. Now, go back to number two. Still on the left side. And we're going to travel a couple more times. Then we're going to bring off the trick number three. We're going to take a piece of tape and tape the upper side of the printhead. What is upper side? FFC side, okay? We're going to tape it all the way and make sure that it's all sealed. And here, I don't know what you call it, water floss or water pick. We're going to point the water pick downward, okay? Don't push upwards and get as closer as possible, because if the FFC cable get wet, and you're going to burn the printhead. And this is going to clean all other cars too. What do I say? Magic. And this one we need a triple check. Make sure the FFC cable is dry. Perfect. And now we have all three printheads that are ready to be glued back. And remember at the beginning of the video, I showed you the 4 points to secure the printhead. We're gonna use epoxy. Any kinds of epoxy gonna work. However, we really like this kind because most epoxy gonna have a long drying time, but this one can be dried in a couple hours. This is AB tube. As long as you do not mix them up, they are this keep liquefied. So make sure when you take off the cap and you're putting back in the same direction, so don't mix up the two parts. And we're gonna mix the two parts together. And all we want to do is lay on top of each point, and we sort like forming a cap. It's not for you to glue the whole tube together, so. It's very easy, just dab it. As long as the top is covered, you're done. And don't worry, this is reversible. If in the future you need to open it up again, just do the same. The top epoxy is going to pop out, and you will be able to rework on your printhead. That looks perfect. And we're going to take it off the clamp, and we're going to recheck or seal over gasket installation, so make sure the water doesn't come from the underneath, it come out from the nozzles. And I'm gonna check each color. And here's number 4 trick, that when I install it, I don't do the cleaning. Your printer gonna have a cabin station gonna have a waste tube. The waste tube going to go all the way on top of the waste tank. You start a printer and wait until the printhead is parked. Then you draw a whole 10 mil and just hold on to it. Hold it for 10 to 15 seconds. You're going to see the ink, then suddenly get a rush in and hold it for 2 more seconds. Why there's no black? Oh, my black damper is not pushed down. So it looked like there, but it just floating on top of the printer carriage. So I didn't get a black ink. So again, I'm going back to the waste tube and just draw and hold. Okay, make sure it's pushed in. This is the original speed. That's how long I hold for. And once I see the ink rushing, I can put it back and print another check. This just save you cleaning and cleaning and cleaning. This is one time is equals multiple cleaning. And let's take a look. That's what I call perfect. And for you, your programmers use the printhead right away, but for us, it could be like a couple months until we use this printhead. So what I do is get a BCH weather solution. Just search the word weather. It depends on how long you're going to save it. For us, it's probably take a month, so we're just going to use the original concentrate. And when you inject, you're going to feel the printhead stop the flow really hard. It feels like clogged, okay? So you push until you feel it's clogged, okay? Just one little squeeze is going to save it. After doing this, you can put in a plastic bag, put in a cardboard box, even open air, it's going to save a couple months. And you can re-inject every 6 months. Second, yeah, we're going to just do a check for gasket. And we clean by clean, we draw ink twice. And it seems to get a couple spots. And we're going to rest for a couple hours and do the third time. And the third time is exactly the same spot. So we're going to take this printhead out and do the next level cleaning. Okay, I'm going to get another video. This gets too long. And I think the folks in Hawaii are going to get impatient. Okay, I'm going to do the second level cleaning in the next video. Yeah, for this actually I did four cleanings. And the key is you get a missing spot at exactly the same place. There's no improvement across all four of those. We'll save the printhead for the next video. But consider this printhead was from trash. So we're pretty much going to save another printhead. I always save with a last another check. So when I do next level cleaning, I know when to start. And the time for the third printhead and the last printhead. Yeah, I just remember the second printhead was the one that we used. We used the water pick, and that one was really severely clogged. Yeah, I am not surprised there are a couple nozzles left to be done. Again, this printhead should be really, really sturdy. And unless it's electronically burned, you can almost certain it can be recovered. And this one, remember, we work on the black, but it seems to get some problem with magenta and the cyan. Okay, let's take a mental picture. The cyan is perfect, but there are about 1, 2, 3, 4 spots missing on the magenta. Fast forward, I'm going to fix all three of them. Just notice there's one missing right here. For small things like this, I just sit overnight. And here's the second day. And yesterday's sign was perfect, but now it has a break here. So don't worry about it. Yesterday was perfect. There's no reason other than air bubbles to break it today. So it's not clogged. So just ignore the sign. And all the magentas are fixed except this slot. Remember, this is exactly the same slot from yesterday. For removing air bubbles, you just use the printer's built-in cleaning function. And those should take it a while. See, that missing pixel that was missing here, now it move over here. Actually, it's not moved there. It just another air bubble happened to be on that line. So I wouldn't worry about it. All the colors are unclogged. Even I didn't have final perfect picture. I'm fine with this printhead, so I'm going to just save it. And we will retest, reuse it whenever we put in a printer, so I'm not overly concerned about this. All right, we took three printheads from trash, and we successfully unclogged two of those. And one more, we need further analysis and repair. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Visit us at bchtechnology.com or locally, Greensboro, North Carolina. Cheers.